What's up, guys? This is Brent with Western Equipment, and in this video, let's go ahead and jump right on in talking about this John Deere Z330M. Now, where we always like to start is going to be back here at the engine to talk about what engine we've got in this and where all these service points are. Now, what we're going to have on this machine is going to be a 23 horsepower Kawasaki engine. Now, if we look right back here on the air filter cover, what you're going to see is 23 horsepower and it being branded John Deere here right on top. But if we look over on the right hand side of the engine, we will see that Kawasaki sticker ensuring you that this is a Kawasaki motor that is on this machine. Now, as far as maintenance points on this engine, starting over here to the right hand side, what we're going to have is this yellow cap here is going to be our dipstick and engine oil fill. So right here, if we go ahead and unscrew that cap, pull that out, we can see that right there is our dipstick, able to check our engine oil level very, very easily. Then right below that is going to be our engine oil filter. And then we're also going to have our drain tube here. Now, this is actually going to be a hose that comes off of the side of the engine that we can move from place to place, depending on what is easiest for you to drain it. That is the nice thing about these hose style oil drains, is that you can move them to wherever you need to, that you can fit that oil pan underneath. Now, moving along the back side here, what we're going to have is this is going to be a V-twin engine, so we are going to have two spark plugs. So one of them is going to be right here, and then we're going to have a corresponding one on the other side right over here. Now, right here in the dead center at the top of the engine, right where we talked about that 23 horsepower sticker, this is going to be our air filter. So it has a very, very lift up lid here that we can just simply pop this up. Right there is going to be the air filter, very easy to change. All we have here is a clamp with a little hand screw here on the side where we can take that loose, change this filter, and be on our way. Now, as we move over here to the left-hand side, a couple of things we're gonna have here is gonna be our fuel pump right up here on the engine. This is gonna be a service point if we're having those fuel issues. Maybe we're having trouble starting. Sometimes what happens is that these fuel pumps go bad. They're very, very easy to change out, and they're a fairly cheap part to change out if you are having those troubles. And then right in front of that is going to be our fuel filter located right here. Now, while we're back here at the rear of the machine, one other thing that I'd wanna talk about is going to be our transaxles. These are going to be our actual two driving motors on this machine. And on the John Deere Z330M, what you're going to have is the Hydro Gear EZT-D heavy duty transaxles with the 1-inch axles going out to both of those rear wheels. Now, this is going to be kind of in that mid residential spec level. You do have lower grade transaxles that you can get into, but the Hydro Gear EZTs are going to be kind of in that mid residential range. So this is great option for this machine. Now, on these transaxles, one thing that we need to keep in mind is that these are going to have a oil reservoir that is going to be located underneath the seat, which I will show here in a minute. But also, these are going to be the driving motors. So whenever you have this machine stopped, these motors are going to be locked. So if you need to push or move this machine, simply undoing the parking brake, which is at the levers, which again, we'll show here in a minute, is not going to allow you to push this machine. So if you are in that situation where the mower will not run, where you're having issues getting it started to be able to move it, and you need to move it very quickly, you do have two transaxle release levers, one for each of these motors. These are going to be located right back here at the back. You're going to see this little silver lever poking out, and to release those transaxles to be able to push this, we're going to raise up on that lever, pull it out, get it stuck down in this notch, and you have to do that on both sides here to release those transaxles. Now, also at the rear of this machine, you may notice that it is clean. There is no hitch, there is no bumper, nothing like that that comes standard from the factory on this machine. But just know that you can add those things. You can utilize this machine to use those rear pulling implements, such as those spreaders, maybe those leaf rakes, whatever those different things are that you need back here at the back, you can do that. But you do have to add an attachment to be able to get that hitch at the rear of this machine. Now, if you'd like to see these things, I have a video showing all of the attachments for these John Deere Z3 mowers. I'll make sure to leave a link to that in the description below. Now, two other maintenance points that we need to be aware of are going to be located underneath the seat. And very easy, we can flip that seat up to get it out of the way. And what we're going to have underneath here is going to be our fuse panel, for one, that is simply covered by this little box right here. And then also right in front of that is going to be our battery. So those are the two service points that we need to make sure that we remember underneath the seat here. And then also underneath the seat, we are going to have our service interval chart right there on board, so that you know when you need to do those different types of services on this machine. Now, while we're underneath the seat here, one other thing that I'd point out is we do have a dual spring suspension system on this seat to help with the ride quality whenever you are in the machine. And then also we can see just how open it is to everything. So if you're needing to do any repairs to this machine, if we're needing to access our control levers or maybe our height adjustment knob or the top of our fuel tank where our fuel hoses go in, you have very good access to all of that when we have the seat flipped over and out of the way. Now, these aren't really service points, but these are a couple of things about the bottom of the seat that we need to know other than where our service interval chart is. For one, is we are going to have a seat switch on this machine. This is going to act as a safety to make sure that there is an operator in the seat whenever you are operating this machine. So we need to make sure that this is plugged in all the time. If this happens to get corroded or gets unplugged, that is going to hinder you from starting this machine and it running normal. So we need to make sure we're taking care of this. Then also, if we're needing to adjust our seat either forward or backward, this is going to take place underneath here. What we're going to have is a turn knob right here that we can very easily take loose. We can simply just twist that off by hand. And then once we have this off, then we are able to slide that seat. If we raise this up, then that seat will slide into those different positions. Now let's talk a little bit about our front caster wheels and the frame of this machine. So on the Z3s now, as of 2023, you are going to have sealed ball bearings here where your caster axle goes into the frame of this machine. So before, these had plastic bushings in them, and now you have these sealed ball bearings. So this is going to make for a lot longer lasting pivot point on these mowers. Now, whenever we're looking at the frame of this machine, what you're going to have is you are going to have 2-inch by 2.5-inch steel tubing running across the front here, moving to that 2-inch by 1.5-inch tubing going down the side of the frame here. Then you're also going to have the foot platform here on top. This is going to be easily removable. We can simply raise up right here, take this foot platform off so that we have access to our deck and our belt underneath, making for easy service and easy cleaning when we need to get to those areas. Next, let's talk about the mower deck on this machine. Now on the Z330M, you are going to have two different deck options. You are going to have a 48-inch XL deep option or a 54-inch XL deep option. Now both of these are going to be made out of 10 gauge stamp steel on these decks. So they are going to be all one piece. That means no welded corners, means less places for clumping to happen underneath the deck. It's going to add to better airflow by having all of those smooth edges on the inside of that deck to overall increase the cut quality of this machine. Now, some of the other features that you're gonna see on these decks is we are gonna have flip up spindle covers, making it very, very easy to clean and service around and under that spindle. These also are going to have grease zerks on each one of these spindles, and on the either 48 or the 54, you are going to have three spindles, which means three blades on either size of that deck. Now, some other things that you're going to see here is you are going to have a washout port on this deck. You're going to have steel reinforcement over here on your trim side that is welded on. And then you are going to have adjustable anti-scalping wheels on the front on either side of these decks. Now also on the discharge side, over on the right-hand side, you are gonna have a very wide opening there. That's also going to be an advantage of this deck over some of the others, is having that wider discharge chute to be able to process more material a lot faster. So now let's talk about the operator station. First and foremost, the seat, where you're gonna be spending all your time. And what we have is a 20-inch high back custom tailored seat, meaning that you are gonna have these cut and sewn patterns. This is gonna be made out of a lot better material than what we have seen in the past. And this has been upgraded to make sure that these seats last over the life of this machine. Now, whenever we're getting onto the machine, one thing to keep in mind is that with the zero turns, sometimes these can be a little challenging if you are one of those people that does have mobility issues. But the good thing is that if you do have to make that step up onto the machine, we do have handles here that we can hold on to and use whenever we are getting onto that machine. So if I go ahead and get up and in to this Z330M, first thing that let's talk about is going to be our control levers. Now, like we talked about before, these are going to be the levers for the driving action of this mower. Now, since I am here not at a local dealership, I do not have the access to turn this mower on and start it to give you a driving tutorial, but we'll go over that here talking about it now. So whenever we are driving these mowers, this is going to be a lot like driving a bicycle. This is how I explain it to all my customers, is that if you have ever ridden a bicycle, then you can drive a zero turn, because the way that these control levers act are going to be just like how your handlebars act. So on a bicycle, if we needed to turn to the left, what we would do is we'd be holding those handlebars and we would push our right hand forward to be able to turn to the left. Well, that is going to be the same thing here on a zero turn. If we want to make that left hand turn, we're going to push our right lever forward. And what this is going to do is make this right hand side spin faster than this left hand side, causing you to turn to the left. Now, if we want to go to the right, it's going to be the complete opposite. We're going to push our left one forward just like we would on a bicycle, and that is going to turn us to the right. And then if we want to just go straight, we're going to push both of those levers forward at the same time. Back is going to be both of these levers back at the same time. Now, with these control levers, I talked about there being a parking brake on the transaxles. Well, where that parking brake is not going to be a handle or a foot press lever or anything like that. It is right here in your control levers. So when your control levers are pushed out, that parking brake is set. Whenever they are pulled in, this is going to disengage that parking brake. Now, as far as all of our functions go in the operator station, we'll start over here on the left hand side. What we're going to have here is, for one, our fuel tank here. This is going to have a tethered cap to it so you don't lose that, and this is going to be a 3-gallon fuel tank. Then right in front of that, we are going to have our beverage holder here, and then of course, like we talked about, we do have our control levers. Now, one thing about these control levers to help with operator comfort is these are going to be adjustable. So we're going to see these bolts here that go into that control lever and into this bracket. We can see these different adjustment spots here where we can lower these down or raise them up depending on the height of the operator. Now, moving over here to the right hand side, what I'm going to have is my raise and lower pedal here for my deck. So this is going to be just a single action pedal, meaning that once you push this in, that is all it's going to do. It does not have a locking mechanism, but to change that height, we are going to have this turn dial over here that we can simply spin from 4.5 all the way down to 1.25 in quarter inch increments. So once we let off of that pedal, that is going to lower down to whatever we set this at. Now, on a lot of other zero turns, you're going to have a locking position. Then once you push this in, it's going to lock into position and stay at that height. But with this one, you are going to be at the height that your knob is whenever you let off of this pedal. Now, also over here by that height of cut adjustment knob that I was just talking about, we are going to have our blade control here. It's gonna be our PTO button, PTO switch, blade control switch, whatever you wanna call it. This is how we turn our blades on. If we raise up, that is going to turn the blades on. If we push down, that is going to turn the blades off. Then next to that, we are going to have an hour meter. Back behind that, we are going to have our dual lever choke and throttle system. So here we are going to have this orange lever for our throttle, and this black lever here is going to be for our choke. So right there, we have that dual lever system. Now, you do have to make sure that once you choke this machine, whenever you're taking it out of choke, you do have to manually put that back out of choke. If not, you can leave that choke on, and that is going to be messing with your fuel to air ratio and really cause you some issues whenever you're trying to be driving. So just make sure that after you've choked this mower, you reach over, turn that choke back off. Right next to that is going to be our key switch right here. Now, you'll notice that this does have a lights position on it, so therefore you can add lights to this machine that are going to be controlled right here at the key switch. This model specifically will not come with lights from the factory, but you can add those to this machine if you'd like so. Then right back behind the key switch is going to be a storage compartment here that is also going to come with a tool. Now, this tool that comes on board here is going to be used for a couple of different things. For one, it's going to be used to adjust our control levers. So this is going to have a 13-millimeter socket on the end of it that you can use to take loose these bolts here for your control levers. And then also right down here by each control lever, you are going to have these two bolts. These are going to be used to adjust your tracking. Now, if you're not sure what tracking is, I've got a video on this and what this does that I'll leave down in the description below. But basically, this has to do with how your control levers are functioning and whether you are driving the same speed with each lever. Now, let's talk a little bit about our model number, the price, the warranty, and the dimensions on this machine. So our model number, Z330M. How we break this down is Z here is going to indicate that this is a zero turn mower. Then the 3 is going to indicate that this is in the 3 series family. So within these Z-Tracks, we have Z3s, Z5s, Z7s, and Z9s. So this Z3 is going to be the entry level series of mowers. Now that 30 there is going to indicate, the second 3 is going to indicate that you can get either a 48 or a 54 inch deck in this mower. And then that 0 is going to indicate this is a Kawasaki engine. Now that last letter M is going to be our trim level indicator. So in these mowers, we can have, much like in a lot of the John Deere lineup, have an E, an M, or an R on that trim level. And that's going to indicate the amount of features. So an E is going to be your economy level or base level mower with the least amount of features. M is going to be more your mid-spec model with the middle class of features. And then R is going to be your loaded out machine with all of those different features. Now, whenever we're talking about price on this machine, I know this is a huge one, so we'll go ahead and get it out of the way. Whenever you are looking at this Z330M online on Deere.com, the list price is going to start at $37.99. Now, keep in mind that is going to be for the 48 inch deck. It's going to go up some once we go into that 54 inch deck. And then also, this can vary depending on where you're at and what the tax class is on these mowers. That is going to affect it too. So make sure that you're taking all of those things into consideration. But what I tell everybody is, whenever you're going to price one of these mowers, make sure to check around. Make sure to see if wherever you're buying this mower at has certain discounts for you, if there's any incentive programs, any of those things that you can get into to help you cheapen up this mower. Now, as far as the warranty goes, what you're going to have is a 3-year 200 hour warranty on this machine to make sure that you are covered for either 3 years or 200 hours, whichever comes first. So make sure that you're taking advantage of that, and also look into the added warranty if that is something that interests you. If you want just a little more protection, a little more peace of mind, make sure that you're looking into the added warranty that you can do on these machines. And lastly, let's talk a little bit about specs here. So overall length, we're going to be at a little over 75 inches long. Height, we're going to be just a touch over 44 inches tall here at the top of the seat back. And then width, whenever we're talking about width on these mowers, a lot of people think that if we have a 48 inch deck, then that machine is 48 inches wide. But what you're not taking into account is the little bit extra on each side of the deck, and then also the deflector. So on this 48 inch deck, your overall width with that deflector down is going to be closer to 62.5 inches. Then we move to the 54 inch deck, we're going to be looking at 68.5 inches. And then speed is a big one. Of course, whenever we're looking into getting these zero turns, we're looking at getting more done faster. So what you're going to have is a top forward speed of 7 mph and a top reverse speed of 5.5 mph. So guys, that should be everything that you need to know about this mower to help you make that purchase. So I hope this video helped you out, and I hope that you liked this video. And if you did, we just ask you to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Also guys, if you need any John Deere parts at all, make sure you're going to check us out at 247parts.com. And as always guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Hey guys, make sure to check out this cool video and this one. Buy your parts right up here and subscribe right here.